रखे। आर्या जी, कॉस्मा अंकल, लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, आई कैन नॉट बिगिन टू टेल यू व्हाट एन ऑनर इट इज टू बी द टोस्ट मास्टर फॉर दिस कॉन्वर्सेशन। आई एम द यंगेस्ट सन ऑफ द ओल्डेस्ट ब्रदर, एंड व्हेन शेरिल आस्क्ड मी टू बी द टोस्ट मास्टर, आई वाज ऑनेस्टली लॉस्ट फॉर वर्ड्स, मोर सो बिकॉज़ शी सेड दैट आई विल बी रिप्रेजेंटिंग माय लेट डैड, एंड इन माय बुक्स देयर इज नो ग्रेटर ऑनर, एस्पेशियली व्हेन इट कम्स फ्रॉम माय फैमिली। I'm a sales person by profession, and as you know, we are a breed that's paid to talk. And as long as we say it with total confidence, we can get away with actually saying almost anything. Yet probably for the first time, despite a 27-year career, I was at a loss for words. You know, probably because I had so much to say, and thus I felt the need to write down the script. This is simply because I wanted to ensure that I say everything that I want to without missing anything, and with the same emotions that I have in my mind. So please bear with me. And yet as I read this, I'm sure another aunt of mine is gleaming with pride at seeing how organized I am. Yes, my auntie, I will say cheers to you at the end too. Annie auntie and Cosmo uncle, I honestly don't know where to begin. So I'm going to begin with what is foremost in my mind when I think of both of you. I have grown up seeing the friendship you, Cosmo uncle, shared with my late father. And to me, both of you were more best friends than brothers-in-law. And so naturally over the years, I've always seen in you a father figure, someone whose mere presence reassured me that there is someone I can reach out to when I need an elder shoulder. I say this with complete confidence and sincerity because, as you will remember, I was the first one to get to know Dad's diagnosis. And at the age of just 18 at the time, I rode straight to your place. You and Annie auntie were the first to hear it from me, and I vividly remember the shocked yet reassuring look. I remember clearly leaving your place with a renewed confidence, knowing I had someone to fall back on and was able to then share the news with my brothers. Right through Dad's final months and even after his passing, you were constantly there to help and advise whenever I needed it. So for all those times, though I have said this before, there is no better opportunity than today to once again thank you both for being there for us at all times, and I know I can say this on behalf of my mother too. I've had the honor and pleasure of having a ringside view of most of the 50 years that you have spent so happily together. And I know there are quite a few life lessons we can learn from you both. I know and have often heard from my parents of your day-to-day struggles in the early years of marriage as you were setting up your family. The one thing that always stood out is the fact that outside those really close to you, and by just looking at knowing you, nobody would know that there was even a struggle. The way in which you patiently, dedicatedly, and with sheer confidence went about building your family and home brick by brick will always in my mind be a shining example of how to face life. You will be very happy and proud to know that qualities such as these have been very well absorbed by your three children. Annie auntie, you are a shining example of patience, a soft yet firm approach and quiet efficiency in anything you do. Never have we heard you complain or boast, just a sheer determination to face the next day and all it has to bring. Every time I've spent time with Carol over the years, and especially when I travel to the US, I clearly see those qualities deeply engraved in her. All of us in my generation, as well as the young millennials, can do a great deal of good for ourselves if we were able to practice these qualities you have demonstrated over the years. I still remember the times during the vacations when Selvan and me used to spend a lot of time at your place with Carol and Cheryl, playing cards and generally having fun amongst cousins. You both would come back from a long, hard day at work and without even a short rest, wanted to know what snack you could make for us to have along with our tea. Your tenderness and care will always stay with us, and we truly admire you for that. Cosmo uncle, growing up, you always came across as the very strict, no-nonsense dad. But we all knew that beneath the tough exterior was a very soft, loving father who absolutely doted over his children. One thing that I treasure and which you and my late dad had in common was how you all made time to be an active part of your children's achievements. I clearly remember the days in school when you used to come watch Savio participate in sports and the sheer joy and pride on your face in his sporting success. My dad was exactly the same, and I can tell you that when I look back, that is one thing I absolutely treasure about my dad, and likewise, I am sure your children treasure about you too. I know how much your children used to look forward to Thursdays when you had your weekly off and used to be at the school with hot lunch for the children and later again to pick them up when school finishes, often patiently waiting and watching Savio practice his athletics and cheering him on. Another great characteristic about Uncle Cosmo that I really admire is the fact that despite the humble beginnings, day-to-day struggles and challenges, he never stopped having fun. I will really have to think hard to remember a time when I did not see him smile, no matter what the situation. Many people in my family consider me to be the brat of the house, someone who's always up to some mischief and pulling people's leg. Well, what do I say? I've grown up watching and learning from the best. Some of it, of course, was a direct gene transfer from my parents. But the balance is from watching my dad and Uncle Cosmo doing their kidagiri and being the life of the party and family get-togethers. My mom reminded me the other day about an incident that will tell you what kidagiri was in those days. It was a D'Souza family tradition to attend midnight mass on Christmas and New Year, catch up for a quick wine and cake thereafter at Quartergate, and then go home. One New Year, our Quartergate family decided to skip midnight mass and go the next morning. In a time when there was no Facebook, Instagram, WhatsApp to let everyone know what you were doing or not doing, there was no way for the rest to know of this plan change. Post midnight mass, the two brats, Uncle Cosma and my dad, decided that there must be a punishment for this transgress. And behold, at 2 o'clock in the morning, we were banging on the doors of Uncle Simon's house, made sure to wake up everyone, including some irritated neighbors, make them give us cake and wine to complete the tradition before finally returning home. I think for a long time thereafter, nobody missed midnight mass again. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is my next life lesson. Let people always remember you for your ability to always have fun and have a smile. Tough times are subjective. Everyone has them, whether you're a billionaire or a pauper. But having a smile doesn't cost you anything and only helps you make someone else smile, something that our world as we know it needs a lot of. As I was preparing to raise this toast, I asked your three children two questions. First, what is the thing that comes to their mind when they think of their parents? And second, what is the most important life lesson they learned from their parents? Annie, Andy and Cosmo Uncle, you'll be proud and happy at the same time to know that you did a fantastic job in setting up your children for life. Let me share with everyone what the three of them shared with me, because I believe there's a lot we can learn from this glorious couple. Both Carol and Cheryl, in their own words, fundamentally said the same thing. Our parents have taught us to live within our means, not chase an extravagant lifestyle, be content with what we have, and contribute in whatever way we can to help the less fortunate, especially with our time. Be patient and persevere towards your goal. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm sure you will also join me in acknowledging that indeed when you absorb this guidance, it is absolutely no surprise that this couple has had so many years of happiness. I call out Savio separately because I was indeed deeply touched by his response, and I'm going to quote him verbatim in his own words. He says, "I have learned tons of amazing things from Dad and Mom, but the most valuable piece of advice Dad gave me in 2018 was a simple three-step process I applied every single day ever since. Step one," he said, "is be brave, son. Step two, work hard. Step three, just leave the rest to God." These virtues of courage, hard work and faith I have absorbed from my father. He has been the living example of these virtues. The most important learning from my mom is her undying confidence in me. We ought to have it in people we love. It has helped shape my life. Today, as they celebrate their 50th wedding anniversary, I want them to know they have been instrumental in all my successes. End of quote. In conclusion, Annie, Andy and Cosmo Uncle, I want to first and foremost congratulate you on the completion of this golden milestone. But more importantly, on behalf of all your family, friends and colleagues, I want to thank both of you for the living example you set and for the wonderful example of love that you both demonstrate towards each other and towards your family. Without saying much, you have taught us a lot of life lessons. And if we are able to emulate even a little bit of what you have taught us, not only will we be very happy people, but the world needs many more like you to make this planet a better place to live in. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in raising a toast to this golden couple, wishing them many more years of love, happiness, togetherness, and most importantly, as they have always demonstrated, a life full of fun. Cheers, Annie Auntie and Cosmo Uncle. God be with you today and always. Cheers.